So we have with us a great set of panelists who have excelled in their domains and are present with us to provide plenty of insights about CDC placement. First, we have Sahil Joshi, who bagged his placement in Flipkart. Sahil, would you like to introduce yourself?
Yeah, sure. So hey guys, I graduated like very recently from IIT Kharagpur from the Mechanical Engineering Department, RP Hall. Some of you are from the hall. I have been with Flipkart, I think it's close to 1.5 months I've been with Flipkart. Inside of Flipkart, I work on the buy now, pay later charter, which comes under the FinTech and Payments group at Flipkart. So yeah, that's a small intro about me.
So next we have Vanchit Rai, who has this placement in Grow, but unfortunately he is not with us right now, but he will join soon. So next we have Ana Khandelwal, who secured her placement in MX Player. Ana, would you please give us your introduction?
Sure. Hi everyone, I'm Ahana and I graduated this year in May. And I was in MT Hall and yeah, I've been working in MX. It's my fourth month going on, and I'm primarily working towards the web OTT platform. So yeah, that's a brief introduction about me.
So thank you, Ana and Sahil, for such a pleasant introduction.
So today, I, Tanish Mittal, and my co-host Ujjwal Chekhane hope that the audience here will get a good guidance, a fresh perspective, a new strategy that they can apply to their placements. So without further ado, let us get started with the session. Vishal, can you please share this idea? So coming to the foremost important thing, now everyone has a common doubt about how to prioritize companies, like among the various diverse pools, each coming with its own sets of incentives and deterrents. So Sahil, let's start with you.
Okay, so I'll share what my thoughts were and what's not strategy per se, because, but what thoughts I had when I got into the placement season. So the one clear thing that I knew was I did not want to prepare for software roles because I never saw myself as a software engineer. So I pretty much knew then that I'll prepare mostly for the non-core roles. So I looked at the profiles that come, right? So I did not prioritize the companies, but I rather took the approach of looking at the profiles I would like to work in. The profiles that came up were, first of all, product management, since I had a bit of experience while I had some summer interns in the role. I knew the profiles that I'll be targeting will be product management, product analyst, business analyst, marketing analyst, all the analyst roles, and the investment banks, right, that which come on day one, day two, the financial analyst role. So if you look at the number of profiles or number of offers that come from the pool of these profiles, I think those were reasonable for me to be comfortable that I'll get placed well if I prepare for those roles well. And even when you look at it, right, so the strategy that I had was, when you look at product management and analyst roles and the investment bank roles, right, so the skills that I wanted to work on was my case solving skills, my product case skills, because those are a bit different, and the data analytics skills, right, because for analytics roles you will need that, and slightly con preparation. So the way I structured it was, I knew Flipkart comes around, let's say, the shortlist will come around mid of October. So before that, I dedicated much of my time to prepare for all the data, I went through some data courses, learned data analytics, learned, worked on quant, worked on some puzzles, and I worked on my basic case solving skills. So I was not preparing heavily for the consult roles that come, but I was preparing in the sense of that no matter what non-core role you go for, there will be a part of it where you'll be given cases. So I knew this is something I need to work on. And post my Flipkart shortlist came, you get around, let's say, 20-25 days then. So then I prepared for my product role specifically, and I got into Flipkart. If I would have not, I still had now, with the Flipkart's preparation, good amount of product cases, product case practice done. So I would have then targeted all the product management and analyst role during the placements. Yeah. That was the prioritization / strategy I used.
Like that was like a good combination for smart work and hard work. Yeah. So like, Ahana, what are your views on this question?
I was kind of similar because I had no preferences specifically towards companies, but I was partial towards the role I wanted to take up. So I knew that I wanted to heavily focus on product roles and analyst roles. So these are the only two things that I focused much of my time on. I was not interested in software roles, so I did not spend my time over there. And I think, so when you look at companies, personally for me, I didn't really look at whether it's good or bad. All of them were fine to me. I focused on what their job description stated for each role that they were trying to project towards me. So some of the companies had really good analyst roles. Some of the companies had an amazing product programs. So my goal over there was to look at what their job description is. Obviously, try and talk to people who are there in those companies that are trying to come to the placement and talk to them how their overall day is like, what do they do, how is it different from my expectations from the job. So that is how I tried to prioritize the roles rather than the companies that I was aiming for. And if I wanted to look at the preparation, I think since I knew that cases were heavily important in a lot of different roles, I prepared them from the beginning, but I started preparing for the analyst roles as I went ahead with my case. So that is what I did.
So I think you already had like a pretty clear idea of what exactly you were aiming for.
Yeah. Exactly.
So like, we'll move on to the next question.
So Ahana and Sailu were both in the different companies. So I would like to know that what are the general procedure for this company and how you went about it.
Okay. Ahana, would you like to go first?
Yeah. Sure. So Sahil, you will probably explain better about Flipkart. I'm not sure about that. But usually for all product companies, you'll get a problem statement and you'll be asked to make a solution deck on it. So that plus your CV is like the first glimpse of you to the company. And that is the reason, that is the whole way of company to shortlist you for interviews. So that is the first step. And after that, if you get selected based on the deck that you've made or the CV, and some companies like MX Player, instead of asking to make a deck, they actually ask you for sitting in the exam instead because they came a little late. So either of these things, they'll ask you to do that. And if you get selected, you'll be participating in the interviews, which I don't want to give a number, but it can be as low as 2 or 3 and as high as 5. Depends on the company, what their requirements are, what they expect from you, and how hard they want to grill you to make sure that you're the right candidate before choosing you to get selected. But yeah, I think at least for product, you should be prepared to tackle the case deck part first. It's not just the CV, but also preparing a case study, which has equal role in getting you selected for interviews.
Kundali, go. So I'll probably talk more about Flipkart and in general what I saw during the product roles hiring, right? With respect to Flipkart, what we have is, I think people who attended the workshop also know that we primarily don't look at your CV for the Flipkart APM role. What we, the way of shortlisting is your deck submission. With each product role, what you'll see is there will be either a deck submission with your CV, obviously, as Anna mentioned, and or you'll have a test to go through. I think Navi and I think as she mentioned, MX Player had tests, and then you'll have the later rounds. And one additional thing that you have in Flipkart is before, post your interview submission, post your deck shortlist, and your, and between the time that you appear for your interviews, you have a 20-25 day window wherein you will go through 2 or 3 buddy sessions when you'll be preparing for your product cases, and you'll get a lot of feedback from them to on understanding, because in product cases they can go very vague, and as a, for a new person, it can be very difficult to evaluate how they are doing well. So you'll get this feedbacks wherein you learn a lot. So that is the second process in Flipkart, which is not much there in the other roles. And third is going through the interview process. Now, in product roles, you will mostly have majorly, let's say, two kind or let's say three kind of interview rounds. One of them would be guesstimates to check your analytic skills, how cool and how comfortable you are with numbers. Second is your problem solving case rounds, and third is the product thinking case rounds. We can product thinking is more like to see how creative you are, how concepts, if you can think of new constructs, if you can empathize with your customers well. Wherein, let's say, a case of product thinking round would be, let's say, improve or create a Netflix for kids, improve the experience of the calculator that you use in your classrooms, right? The problem solving rounds is to check how structured your approach is, how well do you approach any problem given to you, how to get to the root cause of the problem happening, right? And the, let's say, a case there can be, let's say, the orders on Flipkart are dropping, what will you do for it? Or let's say it can be very vague as the traffic in your city is increasing, what will you do for it? Those are the problem solving rounds, and the first is guesstimate. I think you know well about it. So these are the rounds and the process that you have to go through while you want to set for product roles. Most, it will be 80-90% you will see overlap of the same process in all of the companies. If you have enough time, you will be asked for a deck submission. I think as Anna mentioned, if the company comes a bit late, they'll probably have a test to shortlist you. And don't primarily worry about your CV. It's, if you perform well on that and if you perform on the test well, your CV will be a secondary thing, is what I would say, what I would mention to you specifically. Yeah, that was it, guys.
So that was great insights for gender selection procedure. So now let us move to the next question.
Okay. Most of us have these doubts about this last moment preparation strategies and how to revise all the concepts. Like, which sources should one look for, and like, how should one get a quick and efficient amount of practice in those last minutes? So Sahil, would you like to go first with this question?
Okay, well, I'll start it this way, right? Agar semester mein nahi padha, to end sem mein load to ho gaye. So if you prepare well, I had some semesters where I had prepared well for some subjects, and which I did not have a good idea of what to prepare for at the end. Right? It's all your friends helping you out to get the C and D grades. It's similar for the placement, right? If you prepare well in the, let's say, the 20 days I got for the product case rounds, at the end of the timeline when your final interviews come, right? You will, after going through the process, you will pretty much know what you want to revise. It's just that I think one key call out that I would like to make on which people don't focus is, so they prepare well on the hard skills and they leave all the preparations around the soft skills. So it's really important that you should, so no matter how well you, let's say you're a great problem solver, but what if you are not able to convey your ideas to the other person, right? Think of it this way, for you in the domain of online interview round, it's really difficult for the case rounds to get your ideas, because in the normal physical way, in a physical interview, you will have a book wherein you are writing it and the interviewer can see it. In an online way, it does not work that way. It's all what you are saying that the interviewer is getting the context from. So definitely work on your communication skills at the end. And also, I would suggest, do prepare for the questions where they ask you who you like, tell me something about yourself, what do you like, what are your strengths and weaknesses. Most people don't. Do prepare for that, because let's say if I'm an interviewer, I'm getting 20 candidates who give me a ratawa CV wala, right? I think there are a lot of people who think ki CV mein jo likha hai, us sequence mein bol do. But even as a person, it's not interesting to me when you read out the CV. I've already looked at your CV, tell me something interesting. So do prepare for those questions as well. Those are really important, because those are the questions where they see if you are a good fit in their organization, because you are good on the hard skills, but what if you are not a good culture fit for them? So do look out for that. And yeah, one call out that, see, I saw placement 2 years, for 2 years, right? When my BTech folks were getting placed, I was closely involved, and during my time, the one thing that I see is people panic a lot before interviews. They are like, bhai, pata nahi kya hoga andar. It's like professor ke viva mein kam darenge, lekin interviews mein zyada. So one thing that I want to tell you is that the person sitting on the other side of the table is much like us only. He is there to help you, or interviewer is there to guide you through the process, and not to evaluate very hardly or to see, oh, ye kar diya galat, ab to chalo, khatam hi hai iska scene. He is there to help you. Specifically for product roles and specifically for your case solving, without your interviewer, you'll have no case solved because he is the one who knows all the answers to the questions you ask. So do keep that in mind. Keep a very, I would not say go informal, but keep a very friendly and a very chill chat with your interviewer, and don't panic. Yeah, matlab, if I've like passed out, and it's been 1 year, I've passed out from Kharagpur, it will be people like me only who will be sitting on the other side of the table. So don't worry. And mostly you get campus alums coming to hire you. So they know a lot already. So keep it chill, keep it, don't get nervous before the interviews and all. If you're prepared well, you will anyways be confident around your skills. I think I elaborated thoda zyada, but yeah, what do you want?
No, it was completely fine. So we have Vanchit over here. Vanchit, would you give us a small introduction about yourself?
Hi, I got late because of this product called Microsoft Teams. So ajeeb sa hai, kuch bhi hota hai sa. So my introduction, I graduated last year, as you might be aware, from Department of Ocean Engineering and Naval Architecture. And currently I am working as an APM in Grow, which is an emerging startup in finance. So yeah, that's about it. And about my hobbies, as some of you might know, I like writing on social media, a lot of things. And yes, that's it.
So Vanchit, we were discussing here, like what are some last moment preparation tips and strategies like you would like to give to the placement janta. So would you share some views of yours?
So what I can recall from my experience, couple of things. First is that don't think ki ye khatam ho jayega sab kuch yahi pe. So I think everyone would have said it at some stage. Don't think ki matlab this is the chance ki ab ye mila to hai nahi to sab khatam hai. Just ye sabse important hai matlab ki don't get bullied by the whole matlab peer pressure ki matlab 500 companies mein apply kar diye hain ab jo hoga dekha jayega. Instead like just pick ki a set of matlab pick zone ki I'll apply in, let us say, these set of companies, this is my preference. And बस यही है कि जस्ट डोंट थिंक कि एंड हो जाएगा सब कुछ. देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज विच आर मतलब सर्चिंग फॉर पीपल, लिटरली सर्चिंग फॉर पीपल कि यहाँ पे काम करने आ जाओ कोई अच्छे से. ठीक है, सो इवन आफ्टर दिस प्लेसमेंट प्रोसेस एंड्स एंड सम ऑफ यू मे नॉट गेट द डिजायर्ड फर्म और मैनी ऑफ यू वॉन्ट नो कि वॉट इज योर डिजायर्ड फर्म, आफ्टर प्लेसमेंट ऑल्सो देर इज लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटी. तो जितना मतलब माइंडसेट खाली रहेगा कि हुआ तो हुआ, नहीं हुआ तो कोई बात नहीं. द लेस प्रेशर यू टेक, बोलना आसान है बट द लेस प्रेशर यू टेक द मोर यू विल बी फ्री. और वो 6 महीने के अंदर लाइक लेट अस से यू गेट अ जॉब एंड यू आर नॉट सेटिस्फाइड बाय इट एंड सपोज यू लैंड इन अ फर्म विच यू डिड नॉट एक्सपेक्ट, विच विल हैपन विद 80% ऑफ पीपल इन एनी केस. कितना भी अच्छा प्रिपेयर कर लो, 75-80% पीपल विल लैंड इन अ फर्म विच दे डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू टेक in the matlab according to their expectations. So yahi hai. And coming to product specifically, I will say ki don't solve too many problems, matlab solve fewer problems but solve them deeply. Instead of like koi hota hai ki pura case book khatam karna hai type ki 15-20-25-30 sawal sab kar lena hai, aisa kuch nahi hai. Just pick matlab even if you pick 5 प्रॉब्लम्स, ठीक है, दैट इज़ इनफ. 5 प्रॉब्लम्स को लो, उसको एंड टू एंड मतलब गो फ्रॉम एकदम जीरो टू लास्ट ऑफ दैट प्रॉब्लम. जितना डायमेंशन खोल सकते हो उसमें सारा खोल लो, दैट्स इट. मतलब दीज आर द टू थिंग्स, बाकी तो दिल है सब.
दिस इज समथिंग वेरी सिमिलर व्हाट वी यूज्ड लाइक प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर आर जे एडवांस. लाइक आहना, लाइक वुड यू लाइक टू ऐड समथिंग फ्रॉम योर एक्सपीरियंस?
I feel like everything has been more or less covered, but yeah, I think I hear 2 points which stick out to me so much, one from Sahil and one from Manchit. From Manchit, I really agree that when you solve a case, it doesn't matter whether you're doing it the last minute or you started your prep 2 months ago. when you do a case, make sure that you're able to understand what's happening. You just don't want to get over with it for the sake of completing a book or making sure that you have a tally that aaj maine 10 case solve kiye. It doesn't matter. Even if you solve like a case in 2 days, as long as you have an awareness, kya hua, what happened, what was the problem, and what came out of it, that makes more sense. And ek cheez which I personally did was I used to solve fewer cases, but I used to be more aware about what's happening. So when I was aware ki mera around world mein product related, startup related, tech related ho kya raha hai, I used to have a better confidence in myself ki mujhe samajh aa raha hai ki I'm confident ki wo hua to what are the implications, ya ye user perspective se kaisa decision tha. So these are the smallest of things which made me more confident when I was solving the case. Might not be the best solved case. Maybe there are much better people who are solving cases much faster and at a much better efficiency. But I was able to understand it at a much deeper level. I was able to connect with the people who are using the product and understand from both the sides of the coins. As a person who will be in charge of the product as well as a user who will be using the product. So to me, that strategy helped me solve fewer cases but be better connected with what I'm solving. And one thing that Sahil mentioned was that don't panic, because that is absolutely true. A lot of people would know what they're aiming for, whether it's the companies or the roles, but you'll see a lot of people around you start to apply in each and every company, whatever pops up in ERP. Because sab aas paas bolenge ki yaar is company mein bhi kar lete hain, isme bhi kar lete hain, and saath mein dekhi, you'll be preparing or doing tests together. But point wohi hai ki don't panic, it's not the end of the world. You have to be really calm with the interviewer in front of you, because they're going through the process with you. In products, like Sahil mentioned, it's not about you giving correct answers, it's about exploring that journey together. So that jo bhi aapke thoughts aa rahe, you're bouncing it off like a soundboard to the person in front of you. And they're more interested in your thought process, in how you're actually tackling the problem rather than the solution itself. So I would just like to mention these two main points. Yeah.
Okay, that was great, Ahana. So like, we'll move on to the next question now.
Now coming to the big question, what are the important things to keep in mind for preparation of product deck rounds? So Anna, would you like to begin with this?
It's kind of ironic because none of the companies that I made deck for, I really interviewed for them, but I'll still take the question. The one thing that I really kept in mind was a proper structure and framework. So I would look at the problem statement. I would give myself 1 or 2 days to think about it. What's expected out of it? From a company's perspective and from a user's perspective, how is it creating any impact? That is what I would think about. And then I would start thinking about the users then. I would not jump onto the solution immediately, because when that happens, I lose track of what I'm trying to solve. So I think first thing is that you keep some kind of a framework or a structure in your head when you're trying to solve that problem and make a case study out of it for the product deck. The next thing is that you start thinking about the users, how it's going to impact the users, what would be the possible reach of any solution that you're trying to map out. And as a user, what would be more important to you to see in the product, and as a company, what is at a higher priority. So these are the kind of things that I looked at when I was making the deck. And I personally tried to keep the deck as simple as possible and not try to cram it with a lot of jargon that I would find while preparing for my tech or product cases, because I wanted to convey the idea as easily as possible, and I didn't want to portray an image where I'm trying to show too much. So that's what I did. But Sahil and Vanchit, what were your thoughts?
Sahil, would you like to add something?
Yeah. So I prepared just one deck. So, but what I think Anna has put it well, right? It's not what the problem statement and it's not what your solution will matter. It's how you are able to understand your users well, right? How you're able to empathize with them well, and what they need is how the solution or how the procedure of solving for the deck should look like. Should not start with the solution and then mapping it to users. Ulta mat karo ki solution pehle soch liya aur phir piche reasoning de raha. It should start in a way, and even as a PM in his real life job does, it starts from the users, the problems, and then comes to the solution. In a deck, yeah, it's a bit subjective on what kind of decks would come for different companies. I would rather know more about what happens with Flipkart, because since I'm here and that was the only deck I prepared. So three things, right, in a deck that you should keep in mind is, first is what even they look for is how well of a problem solver and slash user, how well are you able to identify the problem or empathize with your users, right? Empathizing is how well do you understand them. It's what they'll normally look into a PS after giving you a problem statement is how well do you understand that. You're able to identify a problem and then think of it in terms of your users and think what they need. Second is they'll look at your solutioning after that. Once you have identified the problem and understood the users, how do you solve for it? Like how well structured you are, how well creative, how creative you are in your solutions, and how well are you able to map the problems to the solutions that are required, that you have proposed, right? And the third point is communicating your ideas then to the person who will be checking your decks, because as Anna also mentioned of keeping it simple and moving away from the jargon, I think it's really important. So remember this, at this stage, no one expects from you to know every jargon, everything about product management. In fact, we expect that you know nothing. Even that is the reason why Flipkart takes a problem solving workshop at the end of its PPT. So if you keep it simple, look at for this 3 points, that if you are following them well, you're able to identify the problem and think of your users well, you're able to give good solutions, you're able to map those problems to good features less solutions that are asked for. And thirdly, keeping it simple and able to communicate it well to the person who will be evaluating your decks is what matters. I think that is all from my side. Vanchit, you can take it forward.
So since most of the points are covered here, I also have only one deck, wo bhi ek din mein, so I don't have much idea about how to make matlab decks. But after joining the job, I have made a couple of decks. So there is one thing, matlab baki banane ka to sara point it has been covered. One thing I would like to say ki originality is very important in the deck. So what happens ki abhi outsourcing ka zamana chal raha hai, so what people do ki अभी कोई फ्लिपकार्ट में है, कोई ग्रो में है, कोई इधर है, कोई उधर है, तो सारे सीनियर्स को मैसेज कर देंगे लोग कि हाँ मतलब जो 2-3 साल पहले से काम कर रहे हैं वो तो डेक बना ही लेंगे. तो उनसे आउटसोर्सिंग का जो ये काम है ना, दैट इज़ द मतलब लास्ट थिंग विच यू शुड थिंक ऑफ कि आई शुड गेट द डेक फ्रॉम समवेयर या फ्रॉम सम पीपल, और आई शुड कॉपी मतलब सर्टेन आइडियाज़ एंड पेस्ट इट ओवर देयर. दिस इज मतलब not a matlab ideal way to do it, because obviously ab koi 3-4 saal kaam kiya hua hai to uske paas better ideas aur better solutions honge. But what the interviewer wants to check is not that ki how good your solutions are, but your thinking process, jaise ki abhi Sahil also said. So try to make the deck original. Theek hai, 2-3 log aapas mein डिस्कस करके बना रहे हैं, दैट्स अ डिफरेंट थिंग. और उसको कॉपी करना और पेस्ट करना, आउटसोर्स कर देना कहीं से कि 2 दिन पहले किसी से मांग लिया, ये सब नहीं होना चाहिए. दैट इज़ अ वेरी मतलब रॉन्ग प्रैक्टिस. इवन इफ मतलब पीपल गेट सेलेक्टेड बाय शोइंग समवन एल्सेस डेक, दैट्स अ मैटर ऑफ चांस, बट दैट्स अ रॉन्ग प्रैक्टिस इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो अहेड इन द फील्ड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग. ठीक है, बी इट प्रोडक्ट और बी इट एनी रोल, मतलब सो आई वुड से कि मेक द डेक ओरिजिनल, दैट इज़ द फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग. सिट विद अ कपल ऑफ फ्रेंड्स, थिंक आउट सम आइडियाज, मेक एन ओरिजिनल डेक. उसमें गलतियाँ होंगी, इट वॉन्ट लुक लाइक एकदम क्लासिक डेक जो दिखता है एकदम प्रोडक्ट का वैसा नहीं दिखेगा, ठीक है, बट इट विल बी ओरिजिनल एंड यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड कि कहाँ कहाँ गलती है ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ योर इंटरव्यू और इफ समवन रियली क्वेश्चंस ऑन दैट डेक, ठीक है. सो दिस इज वन थिंग विच आई एडेड ऑन टू व्हाट अहाना एंड साहिल सेड. या दैट्स इट.
Yeah, I have one such great point here. I would want to reiterate this. Originality is really important. I think great point. Keep that in mind. Don't try to be smart and copy stuff. It's a good chance that the person evaluating that will know more than you.
So yeah, that was a great point coming from. So now let's move to the next question.
Okay, so this is like a very common question, like whether there is any CG criteria for product profile, and adding to this, how important is the personality of a candidate? So Sahil, would you like to go first?
Yeah, I liked how you you kind of had two questions together which are like totally different. Does CGB matter? Does CG matters or does personality matters? Cool, I'll try to answer. See, for most, for Flipkart, I know for sure your CG does not matter. I'll tell you a very interesting story. While I was in my, during my placement preparations, when I went to Flipkart's workshop, I asked the same question to the guy who was taking my workshop. And that guy said, bro, I had a 5.9 CGPA. Do you think it's important now? So it pretty much answers that for Flipkart, mostly, and not just your CG, but we don't even look at your CV. And I think it, since, so the way you evaluate at this stage to hire an APM, right? The skills that you want, your CG won't reflect. Is the again reason why most companies would want and come with a deck kind of a shortlist to see your how good of a problem solver and a structured thinker you are. And this is the skill you can acquire, it's not like you are born with it. So no, CG does not matter, at least according to me. I don't know if Anna or Vanchit have some other views. Around the personality thing, yeah, I'm not sure how to answer that. But yeah, I think it's rather, it's not the personality, it's the way you communicate it to the it's not like मैं ऐसा हूँ तो मैं select नहीं होगा, वो वैसा है तो नहीं. It's more or less like if you are able to communicate your ideas to your interviewer well, if you are, as I said earlier, right, if you are chill enough during the interview process, it shows, it kind of reflects that, because as a product manager, right, you have to be very, you are the center of all the stakeholders, so most of your day would go talking to people and getting them aligned with all the ideas that you have, and for that you will need good communication skills, and that is a major while even the people look out for while you are in the product case rounds. So I think personality, it's more like your communications and how chill you are during interviews. And for me, I don't think CGPA matters for product profiles, at least. Over to you guys.
So like someone who is aiming for Flipkart can, like from our audience, can be actually stay relaxed about his or her CG.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, online, I think you guys have had 4 or 3 online semesters. Agar kisi ki kam bhi hogi, tab pradesh aur abhi tak badh gayi hogi.
Yeah, that's true, actually. So, Vanchit, what's your take on this question?
See, this is company to company wali cheez hai. Matlab, jaise Sahil said ki in Flipkart, it doesn't matter. And in Grow also, since the founders are all from Flipkart, so it does not matter in Grow also. So company to company wali cheez hai. Maybe there is some company, aisa matlab generically nahi kaha ja sakta ki CG does not matter for product. Aisa truth matlab ekdam eternal truth jaisa kuch nahi hai. Company to, ab jaise startup hai, emerging hai, ya fir utni badi company nahi hai, to usme इट इज़ माई असेसमेंट कि उसमें उतना मैटर नहीं करेगा बिकॉज दे हैव अदर थिंग्स टू लुक फॉर. एंड मे बी देर इज़ सम कंपनी जो 8 CGPA से ऊपर ही शॉर्ट लिस्ट करेगी प्रोडक्ट में भी आगे चल के, वी डोंट नो दैट. सो इट इज़ अ टोटली कंपनी टू कंपनी क्वेश्चन. इन ग्रो आई कैन से दैट CGPA डज नॉट मैटर, क्योंकि मेरे साथ के जो लोग हैं देर इज 8.5 CGPA ऑल्सो एंड देर इज 6.5 CGPA ऑल्सो. तो हाई CGPA is not a very much additional, मतलब कुछ ऐसा जो कि in grow that will be considered. And coming to the personality part, तो मतलब yes, this is a tough question कि personality is a very 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 subjective thing, ठीक है. Maybe personality में बहुत सारे aspects आते हैं, ठीक है. अब if someone is out there to मतलब बेवकूफ़ बनाना interviewer को, ठीक है, तो वो वाली पर्सनालिटी तो मतलब समझ जाएंगे मोस्ट ऑफ द इंटरव्यूअर्स कि ये जो है दिस पर्सन और दिस इंडिविजुअल इज ट्राइंग टू मतलब मैनिपुलेट मी. ठीक है, तो मैनिपुलेशन नहीं करना है. ऑनेस्टी इज़ वन ट्रेट ऑफ पर्सनैलिटी जो कि इमर्जिंग स्टार्टअप जो हैं वो लुक दे लुक आउट फॉर इट. ठीक है, मतलब एटलीस्ट द स्टार्टअप्स विच आर प्लानिंग टू एग्जिस्ट फॉर लॉन्गर तो वो लोग लुक आउट करते हैं. सो ऑनेस्टी इज़ वन ट्रेट इन पर्सनैलिटी विच यू शुड कंसिडर फॉर ऑल प्रोडक्ट प्रोफाइल्स. एंड बाकी तो इट्स अ वेरी सब्जेक्टिव थिंग और कोई जेनरिक ऐसा पर्सनैलिटी ट्रेट कम्युनिकेशन एंड ऑनेस्टी. या दैट्स इट.
या ओके आहना, व्हाट आर योर व्यूज ऑन दिस? व्हाट वर योर एक्सपीरियंस?
आई कैन टॉक अबाउट सीजी फ्रॉम एमएक्स पर्सपेक्टिव. तो एमएक्स प्लेयर में तो आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज एनी सीजी क्राइटेरिया. आई डाउट दे लुक्ड एट द सीजी एज वेल. So if anyone's targeting MX player, be assured CG nahi dekhte. And I agree, I don't know if I can say that for other companies, but I don't think you should fixate on something which you can't control right now. CG, you cannot really change. What you have is what you have, and that's what you're going to take into the placement. So why even bother about it? Apply kar lo. Nahi hoga, to assume कर लेना it's not because of CG, it's some other reason. So don't fixate on CV when it's not in your hands right now. And how important is personality? I don't know how I can answer it any differently because what your personality is, वो interviewer को आधे घंटे में नहीं दिखेगा. All he can see is, as they mentioned, communication. How well and prompt you are in answering their questions, how you're able to answer them without going around in circles and not being upfront about it, not being honest about it. And I mean, iske alawa to I don't think there's any way people can actually measure your personality in an interview, especially an online interview. It's all that you can project in your answers, just to samajh aata hai whether you're actually a good candidate, whether you're culturally fit for that company, or how you are in your product thinking. That's what matters in the interview, nothing else.
I'll have just one other point I think I missed. It kind of stems from the point that Vanchit put forward of honesty, right? I'll tell you one thing, not a personality trait, but one thing that will surely matter is, so your interview won't be a linear thing, right? Ki bahut badhiya badhiya chalte ja raha. It will, even a 45 minute interview or a case round that you go through, it will have highs and lows. What really the look at is, so during a case, it may so happen that you are not able, you are maybe not at the best at a, maybe you went the wrong way, maybe you could have gone the other way. It's really what they see is if you are able to keep your calm and still find a way out of it, because the candidate who loses his calm there and is not able to get out of the pit is not someone probably who will have a good fit for the organization, because even in your job you'll have highs and lows. So keep that one thing in mind. Even if you're having a bad let's say 2 or 3 minutes in your case, you can pull it off from there, and even the last 5-10 minutes will matter on how you go about solving from there. Just one other thing, go on, right?
Yeah, thank you. I think everyone could have got an overall insight about this question. Now we'll move forward to our next question. Ujwal, you are on mute, Ujwal.
Yeah. So now this is a similar question as earlier about PG, that what is the amount of weightage given to PR in the product role?
Sorry, controversial sawal puch lete. Let Anna answer it.
I don't want to say it doesn't matter, and I don't want to say it's the only thing that matters. I would say ki it's not the PORs, but what that POR means in your CV. So it's not the fact that you have been a head in some organization or you're leading something. That's not the gist over here. The matter is ki if you had a POR, you would technically write led a team of four, or you did this and you created this impact, right? So whatever these points that you write under your POR, those are the things that really matter. Or wo zaruri nahi hai ki POR se hi reflect karo. If there is anything that you've done, anything that has created an impact, anything that shows you can work in a team, that you can create something really good out of working with multiple personalities put together in a single group, then that is what matters. I don't think I can say ki POR nahi matter karta ya POR matter karta, but if you don't have a POR, it's not the end of the world. There should be something that you've done in your KGP life that has created a good impact. And now it's up to you how you present it in your CV and how you're able to talk about those points in the interview. Because CV mein, jab I made a CV, mujhe ye bola gaya tha that 7 seconds, even not even second, I think 6 seconds rule hota hai. An interviewer would look at your CV for just 6 seconds to browse through it, and some of the facts will jump out at them, which will be the talking points in your interviews. So maine wo soch ke apna CV banaya tha. I knew that nobody is going to look at my CV in detail before the interview, and interview maybe it's going to be up to me how I talk to them through my CV if that happens. So how you present your CV and how you're able to talk to the interviewer during the interview is what matters, not how many POs you put in your CV. Because screening process mein CV ka utna weightage ho nahi ho, but deck ka and test ka weightage hoga. And even if you don't have a first class CV, you can still have good communication skills and talk about very, very small points and elucidate ki tumne kya impact create kiya hai. Wo matter karta hai interview mein, not the fact that you have, let's say, 10 POs. That's what I think.
So Vanchit, would you like to add something here?
Yeah, nothing more. Matlab, I don't think koi dekhne wala hai itna CV ko detail mein ki POR kya hai and all. But like, if there is something which you can tell, okay. If there is something, let us say, ek do mahine kisi project pe kaam kiya tha, be it jaise Ahana said ki POR hold karte hue kiya ho ya fir aise hi kiya ho, that doesn't matter. People just want to, interviewers, yeah, even if let us say someone of us will take interview 2 or 3 years or 1 or 2 years down the line, so we would just want to know ki kuch bhi aisa jo kiya ho, theek hai. So yeah, there is no much matlab emphasis to POR.
So Sahil, would you like to add something?
Yeah, they have pretty much covered a lot, but yeah, I think I'll just reiterate it once. So the POR as such won't matter, but what you, this is, there are the questions of why and what, why you joined it and what you learned is what you will be, as Ana said, discussing with your interviewer, and that is what will matter. And it's not, don't look at it also in the lens of, oh, will this POR get me a shortlist, versus the skills that I learned while I was on this POR, can those help me in my interviews? Like the things that I learned during my POR as a, with ESL, I was there till my second year. The communication skill, because I used to make, my response team mein tha, I used to make this cold response calls. So it somehow improved my communication skills, which helped me in interviews. Not having ESL on my CV helped me get the shortlist there. So it's like, don't look at it from the lens of, will this land me a job, versus what I've learned in it, how will that help me landing a job. That's
good. I hope everyone is clear about the POR in the product world. Now let us move to the next question.
Okay, so like CV is one of the hot topics during placements, like what to include and what not to include. It's like a topic of constant bewilderment. Now, as Ahana mentioned about the 6 second rule, so like one main question that arises is like, what are the essentials of a good product profile CV? So Ahana, would you guide us on this?
Okay, this is this is difficult now that I don't remember what my CV looked like, but I think what I did was I created a draft and I put everything that I've done ever in college, whether it had a huge impact or it was very, very small. I added all of them when I first made my first draft. And uske baad maine notice kiya ki, since I'm from architecture department, a lot of things are very core. And they didn't really made much sense in a product CV. Jaise I've created a building in my internship. Yeah, fir I worked on this model. These things didn't really make sense to me. Product role mein. So I removed them since I knew I couldn't really showcase them in a way which helped me talk in the interviews. So point wahi tha ki main kya kya aisa dikha sakti hu which will help me create talking points with the interviewer in the interview. Kyunki jab aapke CV grilling rounds honge, so these are the kind of points that will help me make a point ki maine ye kiya, isse maine ye sikha, like Sahil mentioned. Yeah, maine ye kiya, usse it was a failure at the end of 2 years, but I ended up learning this. So maine ye do cheeze dekhi, I could understand what I could put and what I couldn't. But I think what I did was I heavily focused on the awards and achievements, because I had a few which I could portray in a way just to dikhe ki I have worked in competitions around product, and I focused on the side projects that I did, which showcased ki maine product role related kaam kiya hai. I worked with a lot of teams. I was able to create some kind of a product, tangible or intangible, out of it. And what did I end up learning? So maine in do cheezon pe help kiya tha. I didn't really focus much on the PORs because I didn't really have that many. Yeah, that's what I did.
Yeah, that was really helpful, Ahana. So Vanchit, what would you like to add something to this?
My CV wasn't that good actually, so I did not spend much time in making the CV, and I have spent more time in making other people's CV afterwards. So one thing that I have noticed after making many CVs later on and reviewing many CVs, which I did not know at the time of making my CV. So that is ki people try to be too funky, kuch aisa likhna hai jo koi nahi likha ho. I would say ki we should avoid this as much as possible. We should not try to write something based on this ki I am the only person, ya this is something really aisa ki this will break the world, ekdam alag kuch lagega. Try to write normal things which everyone does. Theek hai. That's the easiest way to communicate. If you write too many complex things which many people don't understand, theek hai, to wo samjhana bhi padta hai. If we write something very modern ya kuch ekdam jargon type, jaisa ki pehle bhi Ahana said, to explaining that is 100 times tougher. If we write simple things in simple words, as up to CV submit ho gaye, to point nahi hai discuss karne ka isko. I think so. So try to write things which are common, theek hai, which everyone sort of knows ki haan aisa hota hai, aisa kiya jata hai, ye sab hota hai duniya mein. And that will make you more inclined towards explaining it better. Theek hai. Yes, that's it.
Okay, Sahil, any more suggestions you would like to give to this question?
Yeah, mostly, but what I see is honesty is a recurring thing that you can see, right? Whether we talked about interviews or now when we are talking about CVs, if you are honest on your CVs, you will be confident about your CVs, as both Ahana and Vanchit said. Agar jargons likhoge khud and not by not being honest, at the end of the day, interviewer will know that, oh, this is something you're not confident about, and this is probably not something you did. So be very honest about your CV, because if you are honest, you will be very confident and that will show in your round. I will answer this in a way, don't look at, I think Anna mentioned it in terms of CGPA, ki nahi hua to CGPA reason tha. Same goes for CV. Don't look at CV as a way it will stop you from hiring. If you are good enough, if you have the skills, if you have gotten through the test or the deck shortlist, CV won't matter. You, because tum baithe ho versus tumhara paper mein likha hua unke paas hai. It's more easy to look at you and see how you answer. I'll give you one example. So prior to me, Ishika joined Flipkart as an APM. On her CV, she was from Geology and Geophysics department and she was actually applying for all the core roles. So you can imagine how her CV looked versus what profile she went into. So does not matter what is on your CV until it's honest. Really how you prepare and what all skills are you able to portray during the interviews is what will finally matter.
I think one main point we all of us can like keep in mind is that being true to yourself and the company we are interviewing for. So we'll move on to our next question now.
So acing interview is not at all an easy job, like being confident and honest, and you people know best about it. So would you like to give our placement janta a piece of advice to how to well prepared for CDC interview? So Sanjit, you can.
Yeah, Vanchit, can we start with you?
Yeah.
एक तो ये है कि हाँ तो व्हाट आई विल से कि CGPA CV दोनों के कंपैरिजन में इंटरव्यू इज ऑब्वियसली मच मच मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. इनफैक्ट इफ यू टॉक वेल, ठीक है, तो इट डज नॉट मैटर व्हाट योर CG और CV इज. एंड इसमें भी देर आर टू थिंग्स विच आई विल से. फर्स्ट इज कि मेक द इंटरव्यू कन्वर्सेशन लाइक, ठीक है, मतलब कन्वर्सेशन लाइक ये होता है कि यू आर स्पीकिंग इन अ मैनर इन विच द अदर पर्सन कैन ऑल्सो स्पीक, ठीक है, मतलब यू डोंट हैव टू अनाउंस योरसेल्फ कि यस आई एम हियर ऑन द स्टेज एंड नाउ हियर इज माय स्पीच. स्पीच नहीं देना है, ठीक है, यू डोंट हैव टू गिव अ स्पीच देयर. यू डोंट हैव टू गिव पूरा 0 to 100 तक वॉट एवर यू हैव डन यू विल स्पीक. तो मतलब keep your interview as much as two way as possible, theek hai, keep it in speak things in a manner ki jisse dusra jo samne interview le raha hai wo interact kar paaye, pooch paaye, theek hai. Jaise to some people if you ask ki what did you do in your internship, theek hai, this is a simple question ki what did you do in your internship. Now if you start elaborating all the technical jargons from zero ki I made this something and I don't get an opportunity to think or ask anything to you, theek hai, so that will disrupt the flow of our conversation. Usse acha hoga ki when I ask ki what did you do in your internship ya what did you do in this project, so you speak like 2 to 3 sentences ki ha I was making this thing, so then I will have more curiosity about it ki acha if you were making this thing then what happened. So this is one, ki make the conversation like its flow should be a conversational flow, not a very like speech ya as a announcement type flow. And second thing is jaldi nahi karna hai, matlab this was a mistake that I did in my final round. I recall it very well, it was with one of the founders and I did not know ki he is the founder. I thought ki chalo theek hai, jo bhi puchna hai bas bata dena hai. So he gave me one question, ki there was a website and I had to sort of analyze it completely ki isme kya kya problem ho sakti hai, theek hai. So one mistake that I did, ki I did not understand ki how quickly I have to answer this. So as soon as he completed the question I started answering, theek hai, ki I see this. So he reminded sort of ki take your time. मतलब यू शुड हैव आस्क्ड कि हाउ मच टाइम आई कैन टेक ये वो. तो देन ही सेड कि टेक 10 to 15 मिनट्स टू थिंक, ठीक है. तो एवरी क्वेश्चन दैट द इंटरव्यूअर आस्क इट इज़ नॉट टू बी लाइक रिप्लाइड एकदम इमीडिएटली ऑन द फेस, ठीक है. ट्राई टू गेट अ सेंस ऑफ द टाइमिंग. इफ if your conversation is going well, then the interviewer has a lot of time. And if your conversation is not going well, तो इंटरव्यूअर ऑल्सो वॉन्ट्स दिस इंटरव्यू टू फिनिश एकदम जल्दी से. ठीक है, तो डोंट मतलब लुक फॉर द आंसर एकदम इमिडिएटली कि क्वेश्चन कम्प्लीट करते ही मुंह पे उसके आंसर मार देना है. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए. जस्ट सिट बैक एंड से कि हाँ ठीक है, गिव मी 5 मिनट्स और गिव मी 10 मिनट्स टू थिंक. बाई चांस इफ यू आस्क लेट अस से इंटरव्यूअर डज नॉट हैव टाइम, ठीक है, and you ask ki give me 10 minutes to think ya give me 5 minutes to think, so it is the interviewer's responsibility. He will remind you ki no, we don't have 15 minutes, take 10 minutes. Theek hai, but that should not stop you from asking certain amount of time. Theek hai, yes, these are the two things which I remember from my experience. That
so Anna, would you like to add something from your experience?
I think a lot of it is covered. I remember from my interview, all I did was, because of the case preps, I kind of had a habit of making a structure in my head before I answered anything. So all I did was, whenever somebody asked me a question, I would take a few seconds. Let's say it's not a case, but a general question regarding what I'm doing right now, what's something related to a point I made in my CV, anything. I would still take a few seconds, think about the question, and then answer in a very calm way. So I know it can be a little panicky when you're in that scenario, because you want to make sure that you answer everything that's in your head, and you want to make sure that you impress the person in front of you. But you'll probably impress them more by being sensible in what you answer. And that is only going to come when you take your time, think about what's asked of you and not what you have in your head. Because a lot of times, aisa hoga, jaise mere first, jo first stage tha usme, so I think he asked me a question, but I was in such a chaotic moment ki maine sirf aadha suna and aadha I couldn't even remember ki pucha kya, and then mere dimag mein answer aane lag gaye, and that's when I realized shit mujhe pata hi nahi unne mujhe pucha kya tha uske aage. Did he ask me to do this or that? I am clueless. So then I took a few seconds and I told him, I'm really sorry, could you please repeat the question that you asked? Then he repeated the question in front of me, and then I said, okay, I'll take a few moments and I'll get back to you. So that to me made more sense rather than answering whatever half-hearted answers I had in my head. Wo hai, and ek thing I think which we are kind of constantly telling you is honesty. It might seem ki mujhe impress karna hai samne wale ko, and I will do it any shape or form. Ho sakta hai you'll think of some थिंग जो तुम ब्रैक करना चाहो उनके सामने, या कुछ आइडिया नहीं है बट उसको पता नहीं कहाँ खींच के यू वॉन्ट टू स्पीक इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम, और यू डोंट हैव एन आइडिया अबाउट अ सर्टेन प्रोडक्ट. जैसे तुमसे पूछ लिया कि हैव यू एवर यूज टिकटॉक, एंड नाउ यू आर अ पर्सन इज नेवर यूज इट, बट यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू से नो टू देम, सो यू से येस. दैट्स वेन यू गो इन टू अ लूप होल जहाँ पे इट्स जस्ट मेस्ड अप बिकॉज यू डोंट नो अबाउट समथिंग बट यू सेइंग येस जस्ट फॉर द सेक ऑफ इट. So, सबसे ज़्यादा important होता है that you be honest. कुछ नहीं पता, बोल दो नहीं पता. They'll understand. They're not there to judge you. They're just there to help you out. So, those are the things that I felt during the interviews.
Just one thing I'll add. इससे याद आया कि मतलब मेरे से पूछा था कि have you ever used this Grow app? So, I never saw their product only कभी. दूसरे प्रोडक्ट्स का तो छोड़ दो तो, बट हाँ मतलब उस टाइम एक बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग इम्पल्स आता है कि हाँ एटलीस्ट गूगल पे डिस्क्रिप्शन पढ़ा है तो बोल देते हैं हाँ आई हैव यूज, क्या पता कुछ होता हो. तो वी हैव टू मतलब स्टॉप दिस इम्पल्स, और सच बोलना मुश्किल होता है तो बट बोलना पड़ता है. तो सम हाउ आई सेड कि नहीं आई हैवंट यूज मतलब ग्रो ऐप, आई हैव जस्ट रेड द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑन गूगल.
Yeah, there's literally nothing I can add. Those guys put it really well, yeah. Keeping it conversation light, keeping it honest, and then also keeping it in a way that you don't, so you keep on well interacting well with your interviewers. Yeah, so the one thing comes from the personal experience, right? I will tell you what happens is, no matter how much you prepare at the start of the interview, you'll always be nervous, fatigued. Okay, so what I did was, and no matter what interview you go to, right, the person who's there to take you into, the first question that he'll ask is, tell me something about yourself. Because before starting, he wants to know about you, your background. So what one thing I did was, I had a, in my introduction at the end, I had an icebreaker statement, something of that sort. So I mentioned, people find it very non-intuitive to add informal things in your introduction, but I used to say that I like stand-up and I watch. I'm a big fan of whatever is Akira or Krista. And it always, there was always a reply to that, like, Bakupura introduction mein ho na ho, but it, there always was this icebreaker moment where we talked at least for a minute or 30 seconds about, let's just stand up. And that really calmed me down for the entire interview, and I used to get smoothly into it. So yeah, you can use such things wherein you can drive or dive into the interview in a very smooth process. You can reduce the nerves that you have, be very calm when you start. Yeah, it helps. It's not necessarily that you use that. It can be anything about something, about your POR, any interesting point about your POR, your academic life, whatever you mentioned in your introduction. Keep it very story-like, and you'll have some or the other point which will definitely be asked, what is this? So what happened during this? It comes from what Vanchit and Anna said of having a conversation-like, and use it to break the ice and get comfortable with the interview. It's more important in the online world of it, because offline you are still, you have some degree of informality, but in online it can get real formal and real nervous, can get real nervous. But yeah, that is one suggestion that I have.
This reminds me that since all of our interviews were online, I thought that we'll keep the cameras open. So I'll be able to see their expressions to understand ki main acha kar rahi hun, kharaab kar rahi hun. And then when I went into the interview, I realized only I am keeping my camera open, the other guy is not. And now I'm staring into a black screen and I have no idea main jo bol rahi hun, wo kya hai? Matlab, is it right? Is it wrong? Because seeing the other person's face is like a huge giveaway. Ki aapne mess up kiya hai, nahi kiya hai. Ek chota sa bhi nod mil gaya, theek hai, you're going right. But wo kuch nahi hota online mein. So you cannot let that get to you. Just be really calm in the interviews.
So that's it. So now we have taken some of the frequently asked questions from the panel. So let's move on to those questions.
Yeah, Vishal, can you change the slide? Vishal? Vishal, please go to the next slide.
Tanish, you can play question.
Okay, I'll just say the question, that's fine. So, the first question, like, which was like a very common question, was what is the amount of proficiency required in coding for being selected for a PM role? So any panelist who would like to take up on this question?
Let's not waste our time on this. Zero.
Plus one, it's zero, none. And if you still ask our coding proficiencies, let's not go into you asking me to print my name using printer.
Okay, then we'll move to the another question. Now, which companies require an in-depth knowledge in product management field? Any specific examples you would like to give? Anyone?
Yeah, so look at it this way, right? IT, you are actually graduating from a tech institute. It's an engineering institute. How can they expect anything? How can they expect that you know anything or something about APM roles? They'll have the processor. The processes are in the way, and the APM role is in a way where you don't have to know your, if you're good with problem solving, inherently structured, which you develop as a skill during your interview, all the preparations that you do for your placements, that is what they'll check for. It's really surprising to them. Like in my case, I had done some product interviews. So whenever I used to go, let's say in my third year, when I went post my second year product intern, they were very surprised on oh, I know this, I know that. But it does not matter, right? All the hard, even if you go for products management internship, it's a 2-month internship. First of all, there's not much that you will learn. You will have, I would say, for the product roles, right? For the internships that even I had, there was all the hard skills I learned did not matter at the end of the day. I had to again start from zero to prepare for the product cases. I think my first buddy round also was a bomb. It was a disaster because I was very underprepared for it. I got 2 days to prepare for that, but I started from ground zero to prepare for product role. So no, not the field of product management. You will not be required, you will not be asked what Google Analytics is, what a PRD is and all that. It's just the cases, there are enough resources for you to prepare for product cases and all the case runs that happen during product. I think that is sufficient. I can't think of a company which will check for your specific product knowledge. Over to you guys.
So this question, so next question was asked by a lot of students. Do candidates with MBA have an upper hand at making big in product management roles? So Ahana, would you like to go ahead with this question?
I feel like I'm not qualified to answer that question because I don't have an MBA degree. I can tell you the experience as an undergraduate, but I don't think I can answer about MBA. I don't know. I think it depends on the company. You cannot really have an upper hand compared to anybody else. If you have good problem solving skills, I think that's what matters at the end of the day. But don't quote me. I don't have an MBA degree. I don't think I can answer this question.
Sahil, do you have anything to add here?
Can you ask me?
Yeah.
Yeah, as Ahana said, it's a function of company, and I would say more than that, it's a function of you. Of being a bit narcissist here, but I don't think at the end of the day, your degree is what will matter. Specifically to Flipkart, when you graduate from the APM program, you as a PM1 and the person joining from MBA as a PM1 will be on the same level. Only the difference is you will have upper hand because you have worked 2 years in the industry. Versus he joining as a newbie. I don't see a function of MBA or non-MBA in that. Initially, when the profile started product management, it were engineers who shifted to this role. Because it's a very new profile. It's only 20 years old when the internet boom came along and all the Amazons and Googles happened. When you required these people who solve for users and who think in terms of what users need and then translate it into features. The people who came to this profile were actually engineers who wanted to work on the business side. With the advance of time, with all this developments that have happened, we have MBAs now also working as PMs, but I don't think it matters much. It's a person that will matter. So even an MBA, someone starting from an MBA as a PM1 and someone starting as an APM from an engineering college, mostly depends on the person rather than their degrees. Vanchit. If you have any other
reasons. Yeah, I wanted to know why this question in placement preparation, how does it matter? Because even if kuch bhi hota, abhi to job chahiye sabko. So
why they are not thinking short term, they are like okay. Google ka CEO kaise banenge? MBA karo nahi karo.
Nahi matlab theek hai, that's a different thing, but while preparation these questions should not matter to an aspirant who is just trying to solve some problems and get into some company. But yeah, question wise, so MBA have an upper hand at making it big. So ideally, the MBAs would know it better. And I am not qualified to answer this. In company such as mine, jo ki 2 saal to khud existence ko hua, to 2 saal to MBA karne mein lag jata hai. So इस हिसाब से इफ़ वी सी कि देर आर कंपनीज स्टार्टअप्स एंड इमर्जिंग फर्म्स वो दे आर स्टार्टिंग राइट नाउ ठीक है ऑफरिंग गुड काइंड ऑफ सैलरी ठीक है एंड अट्रैक्टिंग यंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड इन 2 years एज सून एज समवन कंप्लीट्स एन MBA वो कंपनी ख़त्म हो जाएगी देर विल बी अनदर कंपनी तो looking at the cycle of matlab MBA and cycle of how companies emerge and grow and get destroyed and again some new companies come. So looking at that, I don't think ki MBA as a degree bahut zyada important hai for product management in emerging firms actually. Ab jo company matlab ab 30-35 saal se hai and if they are trying their hand at product management, so they will obviously, I think they will prefer MBAs. So this is completely company specific and MBAs would know it better, yeah.
So now moving to the next question.
Okay, so this is something related to interviews. Now, how to answer product improvement questions, like how to know which design will be best, and because we cannot A-B test infinite possibilities. So anyone who would like to go with this question? Maybe we could start with you, Sahil.
Yeah, are there already PMs in this group who are asking these questions? So, see, I'll answer the question in a way, how to answer product improvement questions. The purview of cases where this comes under is product thinking case round. And when you practice enough product thinking case rounds, you'll know how to answer for those. Where you have asked how to know which design will be best, cannot A-B test infinite, this is not related to the placements and your case rounds. It's more related to your experience on the job and how you solve for it. So I will skip the other question. And for the first question, it comes under the purview of product thinking cases, and you will learn how those cases go and how to answer about those questions. And that's it. Vanchit and Ahana, you want to add something?
I don't know if I can add anything to that, because the second question doesn't really mean anything, the placement. And the first question, yeah, I think I agree with Sahil. When you'll go through different type of cases, you'll understand how each case goes about and how you have to tackle that problem. So second question really doesn't matter for placements.
Okay. Anything more you would like to add?
Yeah, so this year, while reviewing some CVs and talking to people, there are a lot of terms which are suddenly become popular in 1 year, that everyone knows ki what is A-B testing, what is, I don't know, even I don't know some of the terms. When I see the CVs, itna sara bhara hua hai, ki this much percentage growth, ye wo. Matlab, it seems like people are already working in some firm for, let us say, 5 or 6 years. उनकी सीवी से ऐसा मतलब आता है. सो डोंट गेट इन टू ऑल दिस मतलब जार्गन स्टफ की ए बी टेस्ट का पॉसिबिलिटी इम्प्रूव, इतना कोई मतलब नो बडी केयर्स अबाउट एग्जैक्ट ऑल दिस. अब व्हेन इट कम्स टू प्रोडक्ट इम्प्रूवमेंट, तो इट डिपेंड्स कि प्रोडक्ट कौन सा है. ठीक है, द आंसर ऑफ हाउ टू इम्प्रूव एमएक्स प्लेयर, हाउ टू इम्प्रूव फ्लिपकार्ट एंड हाउ टू इम्प्रूव ग्रो इज कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट. एंड तीनों के लिए माइंडसेट अलग चाहिए आंसर करने के लिए. डोमेन नॉलेज थोड़ी सी अलग चाहिए सबके लिए, यूज़र नॉलेज अलग चाहिए. सो मतलब एवरी प्रोडक्ट हैज़ अ डिफरेंट स्कोप ऑफ इम्प्रूवमेंट, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ माइंडसेट विच इज़ नीडेड टू आंसर दैट क्वेश्चन. तो वॉट आई वुड से कि वाइल प्रिपरेशन, वन थिंग दैट कैन बी डन इज पिक different kind of products, matlab let us say 4 or 5 different type of products, and try to practice, matlab try to think of it, just think of it ki isme kya kya improve ho sakta hai, and try to discuss with, let us say, not by making a PPT or something, just over a chat ki ha, jaise abhi Microsoft Teams I was opening to get into this meeting, so in that process only I was noticing ki ye to pura matlab khatam hai, kuch bhi ho raha hai, कहीं कुछ टाइप करना है, कहीं कुछ टाइप करना है. तो इवन सिंपल थिंग्स लाइक दिस कैन गिव यू सम पॉइंट्स कि हाँ इसमें ये इम्प्रूव हो सकता है. तो प्रोडक्ट इम्प्रूवमेंट इज नथिंग बट योर डेली एक्सपीरियंस. अब इफ़ यू डोंट यूज, लाइक मेरे से इंटरव्यू में पूछा था कि व्हाट ऑल एप्स डू यू यूज़ एंड हाउ वुड यू इम्प्रूव मतलब उसमें से कोई ऐप, तो दैट टाइम मतलब आई डिड नॉट हैव एनी ऐप इन फोन ऐसे, बस आई सेड कि हाँ ऐप बस व्हाट्सएप मैसेंजर यही 2-3 ऐप है और कुछ आई डोंट यूज, आई ओनली यूज सोशल मीडिया. तो उसमें इम्प्रूवमेंट्स आई कैन टेल बाय माई एक्सपीरियंस कि हाँ इफ़ आई यूज फेसबुक फॉर लेट अस से 11 आवर्स ड्यूरिंग दिस ऑनलाइन मतलब सेमेस्टर एंड ऑनलाइन वर्ल्ड, तो ऑब्वियसली मेरे एक्सपीरियंस पे इतना आ चुका होगा कि आई विल टेल कि हाँ दीज थिंग्स कैन बी इम्प्रूव्ड, इसकी जगह ये होता तो बेटर होता. तो देर इज़ नो प्रिपरेशन एज सच विच शुड गो मच इन टू की प्रोडक्ट इम्प्रूवमेंट का आंसर ऐसे ही देना है, ए बी टेस्टिंग का आंसर ऐसे ही देना है. ऑल दिस विल जस्ट मतलब गेट इन टू योर माइंड एंड इट विल स्टिक देयर कि हाँ.
I think Vanchit is facing some technical issues right now with the teams again.
So
we'll send him to Microsoft as a PM. Don't.
So in the meanwhile, let's take some questions from the audience. The chat box is open. So if it would be great if panelists share their view on the question from the chat box.
So I'll just read out a few questions. So one question is about product improvement. Now, sometimes company ask about their company and they give the solutions in case they already solve the problem. Is it okay to say that the solution isn't the best and point out the problem? Ahana or Sahil, anyone?
I do not get the question. What is the question?
I think he's asking if company is discussing about a product of its own and quite like a problem of its own and given its solution. So is it good to point out that the solution was not the best solution or it was not good?
So a problem is given, a company is giving a problem and also its solution. I really won't get it, but if you have some views, you should definitely share it. I'm of the opinion that you don't shy upon it. So every product that you see will have some will definitely have some scopes of improvement. That is why there are PMs one on the job. So yeah, you can point it out to them and share your views. It works. If I've got the question right, I'm not sure. Anna, do you want to add something?
Yeah, I mean, I don't understand why the company would give a solution to a problem, but I agree. I think if you have any ideas, if you have any thoughts, you can always say it to the interviewer, but make sure that you present it in a way that it's not rude and you're not coming off as a very arrogant person. None of the products that we use are perfect. So obviously as a user, you'll have your own experience, your own understanding of what's right and what's wrong. You should definitely say it, but make sure that you present it in a right way and not just go on and say that product kharab hai aapka, ye kar lo, wo kar lo. Don't say that. I mean, I'm assuming all of you are aware ki kaise baat karni hoti hai interviewers se. But yeah, I think wohi hai that you have to be honest.
Okay, so next question we have is like, can you tell us about some resources for product case practices? Which you followed while preparing for your interviews?
Okay, don't look at it as a biased answer, but there's a Flipkart APM website that we have created, and there's a whole bunch of resources shared there of books and blogs that you can look at. Mostly for your product case preparations, you will have you start from reading, going through the books and going through their cases, and practicing is actually the key, is practicing rather than going just plainly through the cases and reading out the book, because you won't learn without the feedback. So yeah, if you want resources, you can check out the Flipkart APM website. If you want, I'll share the link to it here. And yeah, it's mostly all this very famous books you are preparing for PM interviews, Decode and Conquer and whatnot. You have YouTube videos around different product rounds. You have different websites like PM exercises and whatnot, where you can go and look at how people can see. I like PM exercises because it was like you had one problem statement and you had 3-4 different people answering it in different ways. So you learn a lot, you know, these are the different dimensions you can, we could have thought of your problem and its solution. And at the end of the day, it's more when you practice it rather than how much you go through, what number of cases you go through.
I don't know if I remember a lot of resources, but Decode and Conquer, Cracking the PM Interview, these books are pretty famous. But the goal over here, as Sahil mentioned, is not to go through the whole book. You'll probably take a few questions as examples on how there are different ways to solve them, to go through the questions in interviews, but take them as just examples. They're not the set ideals on how things are answered. And you'll have a lot of online websites and YouTube channels where you can see how people tackle questions, you can understand how things work. And then there are online websites where you can get sample questions, which you can prepare with your case groups. That's all. I don't think you should go through the whole book or the PDF and try to answer everything. But if you're looking for an example on how to start the preparation on how each case is ideally solved, then there are a lot of YouTube channels. You'll find a lot.
Okay, thank you, Sahana, Ahana and Sahil. Vanchit, we have one question for you in the chat box. The question says, as you said, you did not make a lot of decks before. So what made you better than other candidates, as there must be people who have prepared a few decks before? What made you stand out?
मतलब they did not tell me this ना कि why did they select me, ये तो बताए नहीं है, so really मतलब I don't know.
Like, one takeaway from today's workshop is honesty is the best policy. We learned in second standard, अभी बहुत आ रहा है.
So there's a question related to deck, like are like is design elements are important for a deck, like various design elements.
I'll answer it in the purview of Flipkart, right? I really don't know it for other decks, but no, your design elements won't be necessary till the point you are so it's being how well I'll check for how well of a good communicator you are, right? So if you're able to explain your thoughts by being less verbose, means by using less words and keeping a very clean and simple deck is what I look for. But no, you use color schemes well and all the design elements, it won't matter. I've seen a range of decks getting shortlisted on the, if you measure them on the design scale. You guys can answer.
Yeah, Vanchit and Ahana, anything you like to add more to it?
I think it's the content rather than the design that holds value. All you have to do is make sure that whatever you're trying to convey is reaching the person who's reading it. If that's achieved, then good enough. Design may, I don't think they really look at it.
Okay.
I would say ki matlab design kharab nahi hona chahiye, acha ho ya nahi ho, it doesn't matter, but kharab nahi hona chahiye, that's it.
Okay, so I think we have a question which is like, which is for all of you. So Abhishek is asking, based on your experience of working in reputed firms, is it possible to switch to product management after working as an SDE in the same firm? Which one is better option for campus placement, trying for product or taking SDE and then switching to product after some time?
Okay, I'll answer this again in the purview of Flipkart. The first thought of it was, whether you can change from SDE to PM. So it depends on the company if they have those programs in. At Flipkart, you have a program wherein if you are a SDE for some time and you want to shift to other roles, not just product, but let's say strategy as well, there's a incubation program which happens wherein you will spend some time working on it. And if you are good, they'll hire you or change your degree to PM. There's another obvious way of doing it is going through the MBA software, MBA product. That is, I think, the most chosen or most, I would say, most used option that I can see. The other part of it, which is better, no idea.
Okay. Ahana and Vanchit, would you like to add something more to this question? Yeah.
I'll say. So I don't think I can say for every single company. I'll talk about MX Player. People do constantly move to and fro product, and I won't say I know how because I'm still a fresher over there. But I am assuming that if you ever have an inclination and if your work speaks for it, then you can definitely move within the company to different roles.
Okay.
Yeah, I would agree to this completely. In my firm, I have seen people in product who have a background of software as well. And a couple of them have a background of analytics and in machine learning as well. So later on, and I have seen reverse as well, key products the people have moved into analytics. So matlab, it's a very mobile world sort of. Aajkal bahut jaldi jaldi switch hota hai compared to, let us say, 15 years back. So it's not a very big task to like switch from SD to product. Many firms will give that opportunity. And within firm, ye to firm to firm depend karta hai, within firm kitni opportunity hai. But across firms, there is a lot of opportunity. If you are SD in a different firm and you want to move into product, so maybe if you have the skills, it's not that you won't get a chance. And there was this question, another question of comparison, right? Whether it is correct to move direct into product or it is correct to move after SD into product. So this is again, matlab, very invalid comparison because you can't compare these two things. How do you know ki a person who moves into product right now, how do you compare his 2 years of experience in product with someone who moves from SD? These are two entirely different experiences. None is better than the other. So it's not a thing of what is better when it comes to the experience. When it comes to other factors, like you have financial goals, your financial goals as well. So in that respect, there is a completely different comparison. In that respect, you can compare, obviously. And but yeah, sticking to the experience and placement perspective, I don't think these questions should ideally matter now that placements are in 2 or 3 months. Right now, what should matter is whether I should give the interview or not. Nothing else.
Okay, so like almost covered all the questions. There's one question like asked by a lot of people. So what exactly comes in the product management tests? Like what is generally asked in those tests? Anyone could go ahead with this question.
I'll answer for MX since I had to give a test. It was nothing major, just quants, basic probability, anything that you'll be able to answer easily. So I don't think you get asked anything difficult in the product management test.
Sahil and Manchit, anything more? Yeah. Yes, Sahil.
Yeah. Sorry, I did not hear what Anna said. I dropped out from the call, but at least in the purview of what companies come for the placement with their product roles at Kharagpur, ones are who will have deck shortlist, so no test there. The ones who did not last year, at least I know for Navi, there was no product related question. It was a normal quant test that happened. Also, there's another company, Sprinklr, that comes, which will have a test. Even it had a 30 question test, if I remember well. It was a 30 question test. It was for your quant. It was quant based test. So I don't think there's any product test that happened specifically. But I do remember one that my friend had when he was in BTech. I'm dual degree, so I was very closely very closely. I was viewing his placements very closely. So in some there was one company which had a product specific test, but even that test, you had to answer one of two questions, and the one question was around guesstimate. I see it in that. I don't think any company will come with any product specific test. Not sure even how will you go for that. What test will be there?
Okay. Vanchit, what was your experience about the test? Like, did you attend any test? And
yeah, what? I attended the test, but usme hua nahi tha. So in Grow there was no test. And I think out of 15 or 16 product companies that came, 8 or 9 had these tests. If this is my rough estimate, I don't know if it's the correct number. 8 or 9, I think 10 or 12 out of 16, 17. Yeah, but the test was easy. Matlab, that I will agree with Ahana as well as Sahil. The tests are not too sort of be the deciding factor in your selection or not. So the tests were pretty easy, but as you know that nowadays tests won't matter that much. So yeah, tests won't matter in the final outcome. But yeah, overall tests will be easy. Simple CAT type aptitude problem.
Okay, now we really had this was a great question and answer session. So like any advice or last minute tips you would like to give to our placement janta, or say anything that we might have missed in this session? Anyone? Sahil, Vanchit, Ahana?
I would say peer pressure se dur raho aur chill raho during the whole process. I know it can get very panicky and bahut load aa sakta hai pure process mein, but if you keep your calm through the entire process. See, you are studying in a premier institute of this country, right? You are among the top best 5 tech institutes you have. Thoda chill raho placement ko leke, ho jayega. Now, it really, as Vanchit also initially said, 80% of the people won't land in the jobs they are looking for, but in the longer run, it won't matter. So be chill during your process. Don't take a lot of peer pressure on you. Yes, prepare kar raha, toh main bhi kar leta hu. Wo coding kar raha, main nahi kar raha, mereko FOMO ho raha. You will see this happening a lot. Don't worry about it much. Everyone has a different path to achieving their goal. Yours may be different. Don't worry about it.
So, Ahana and Vanchit, would you like to add something? Add some tips to this?
Yeah. So, one way to keep calm is to think ki iske baad aur zyada tension hone wala hai. So, people, matlab, once you stop thinking ki placement se kuch sort ho jayega, pressure khatam ho jata hai. It's easy to say but difficult to implement. Just think ki pressure to hamesha rahega aur badhta rahega linearly, at least until the age you are in working condition. Theek hai, to pressure badhta rahega. If you get the job, don't get the job, phir bhi badhega hi wo. To wo beech mein 2 mahine ka aayega ki thoda kam lagega bas. उसके बाद तो फिर बढ़ेगा ही. तो वंस यू हैव दिस इन योर माइंड कि नथिंग इज गोइंग टू गेट इजी इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ यू गेटिंग और नॉट गेटिंग द जॉब, नॉट गेटिंग द फेवरेट जॉब. जॉब तो मिल ही जाएगी इवेंचुअली, ठीक है. तो हाँ, मतलब जस्ट थिंक कि इट्स गोइंग टू गेट टफ, आगे और टफ होगा, उसके आगे और टफ होगा. सो वंस यू पुट दिस इन हेड, तो इट वोंट मैटर कि हाँ अभी दिसंबर में क्या हो रहा है. आगे और टफ होना ही है, तो क्या हो रहा है, बस यही है.
Ahana, any more suggestions you would like to give?
I think the biggest one is already discussed. We don't be extremely stressed out thinking about what ifs. नहीं हुआ तो क्या होगा? Not the end of the world. There are so many more opportunities out there. Usually ho jata hai, but nahi bhi hota hai, to just think about this. Product companies kuch hi aati hai campus mein, but every company more or less needs a product manager. There is so much more out there, but wo hume pata nahi hota because we're kind of fixated on this 2 month ka process and December ke 10-15 din and that's it. To wo nahi hota hai. So I would just suggest ki be calm, don't think about nahi hoga ya kaise hoga ya उसने ज़्यादा प्रिपेयर कर लिया है, मैंने नहीं किया है. एंड इवन व्हेन यू आर डूइंग केसेस टुगेदर, डोंट बी स्केयर्ड इफ समबडी इज एबल टू आंसर थिंग्स मच बेटर. इट डजंट मैटर इफ यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड कि क्या हुआ उस केस में एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. दैट्स इट, दैट्स फाइन. उससे ज़्यादा डोंट स्टार्ट कंपेयरिंग योर सेल्फ विद समबडी एल्स यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग केसेस विद कि वो बेटर है. आई एम गेटिंग स्टक अ लॉट, मुझसे नहीं हो रहा. या फिर नॉट इवन प्रोडक्ट, लाइक साहिल मेंशन, द पीपल हु प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एसडी रोल्स, द पीपल हु आर हेवीली प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एनालिस्ट रोल्स, कोर रोल्स के लिए कुछ कर रहा है, उन सबका प्रिपेरेशन स्ट्रेटजी अलग अलग होगा. यू कैन नॉट इवन बिगिन टू कंपेयर योर सेल्फ विद देम. सो वो क्या प्रिपेयर कर रहे हैं, वो कोडिंग कर रहे हैं या नहीं कर रहे हैं, वो किस टेस्ट के लिए बैठ रहा है, किन कंपनीज में अप्लाई कर रहे हैं, इट्स इररिलेवेंट टू यू. डू व्हाट मेक्स सेंस टू यू एंड डोंट फॉल इनटू दैट प्रेशर दैट यू हैव टू डू व्हाट अदर्स आर डूइंग. बाकी आई डोंट थिंक, मतलब इट इन रेट्रोस्पेक्ट इट डजंट लुक दैट डिफिकल्ट. उस फेज में यू विल फील लाइक इट्स एवरीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड. बट जस्ट बी काम, देयर आर सो मेनी मोर अपॉर्चुनिटीज आउट देयर, सो डोंट लूज होप.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, thank you, Ahana.
Tanish, I think we have reached to the end. Concluding the seminar, first we would like to thank all the panelists, Ahana, Vanchit, and Sahil, for giving up their valuable time and sharing all the valuable insight with us. It was very informative discussion for all of us. We would also like to thank the audience for being so present and active during the seminar, and also for posting very insightful questions for the panelists. That's it from our side. I hope the seminar proves helpful for all of you. And thank you and have a pleasant evening. That's all from our side.
Thank you, everyone. Yeah.
Thank you. All the best.
All the best.
All the best for
all
your placement.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.